So that's pretty much the base mesh is done, and now we are ready to sculpt. Thank you for watching and take care. Hello, in this video series I'll show you how I can model Shrek. Now you guys may not know this, but Shrek is actually the most requested character that I get, so I think it's about time for me to answer the call. Answer the call to Shrek. So first of all, just look in the description, you'll find this video game model. Now the reason I'm using this is because it just gets us a head start. It does about 5% of the work for us, and just allows us to make this faster. It's a good idea to use resources when they are available. If this did not exist, we could always start from scratch, but since it does exist, we can just start with this. Now, by default, when you import it, it should be very small here, so we should scale this up a little bit. I'll just press F4 to see the edges here. Now, when I select this object here, notice where the pivot point is, and this object as well. The pivot point of all these objects is 0, 0, 0 on the Z-axis. However, if I select both objects, notice the pivot point goes right here in the center. And that's because we have different settings depending on whether we have one or multiple objects selected. With one object, we are using Use Pivot Point Center. With multiple objects, Use Selection Center. So let's just change the setting here. And now we can actually scale both of them using this pivot point right here. An alternate way of doing this is just go into Create, Helpers, Point Helper, and just put the point helper in the center here. Control I to select inverse, and we can select and link both these objects to the point helper, and now we can just scale the point helper up. Let's say 10,000 here.